Tonight, I wanted to show how I edit the EOS R5's 8K RAW footage in DaVinci Resolve. The first thing I want to take a look at, though, is what are the specs of the computer system I'm using to edit that footage, because I think it's very relevant to see how does it perform on a high-end computer, not the highest end, but pretty high-end. I'm using an i7-8700K processor, which when I got it was pretty cool. 64 gigs of RAM, and a 1080 Ti graphics card. So that's just kind of the specs I'm using. First step is in DaVinci Resolve, I've got the project settings set up for a 4K timeline, because really I don't need 8K YouTube videos, especially when I'm shooting talking head stuff like this. Now, fast forward a few years, maybe. Right now, it's just not a thing, it's not happening. So next step is I'm gonna import the footage. And it took about 10 minutes to copy a 12-minute file from the CF Express card to my computer to the SSD. So let's go ahead and import that. And then in order to speed things up while editing, we need to generate the optimized media. And I need to look around my camera to click that. All right, so this part is crucial. This saves a lot of time in the editing. And even with this, you're gonna see that I still have to make some concessions when editing in order to speed up the process. Now, this part here takes a while. It's probably gonna take, I'm gonna guess 45 minutes to an hour to convert that. So let's just see what happens. Now, part of this might be going a little bit slower because I am using the graphics card right now to basically record my screen and accelerate things there. So I'm gonna stop this recording and hopefully this speeds up. Once that's done, I'll go back to this video, I'll start another recording, splice it together, and show you how I edit it. Okay, that's it until this part is done. So it took about a half hour to take that almost 12 minutes of footage and optimize it. So just understand it is going to be a slow process. Now let's go ahead and look back at DaVinci Resolve, and I'll show some of the things I do to make things faster. On the Edit tab, a few things I do. The first thing I do is I go ahead and change it to using Optimized Media and Proxy Mode, which means we're going to use about a quarter of the resolution. That's going to speed things up tremendously. Go ahead and add that to a new timeline. And then here's where you really need to edit things. Now, if we just play it like this,
I've owned other X100 series cameras.
The playback is fine, but we need to go ahead and convert this RAW file. So I'm gonna go to the color tab, and here's what I love about editing the RAW footage from this camera. You truly have camera raw functionality like you would in using a digital SLR. All right, so in the color correction tab, we're gonna go ahead and click on Camera Raw. This is where all the magic happens. And I'm gonna go ahead and turn off my camera. I could just move it off to the corner here. All right, in the bottom left-hand side, here's where all the magic happens. First thing, we're gonna change it to full res Canon. And here we have some options. We can change the white balance. So I'm gonna go ahead and change it to a custom white balance. Bring the color down quite a bit. We'll adjust this more in a moment. And here we can change it to Canon Log 3. So you see I've already made quite a few changes just to the raw footage so far. So I want to output in Rec. 709. I guess I could keep it as Cinema Gamut. But we're starting to see a usable looking image here. Now, if I change to Rec. 709, that's an option here. I could go with that. And that's not bad, but I want to be able to edit it a little bit more. And so this is just kind of what I've found works pretty well. So again, let's go back to Canon Log 3. And this is really cool. You can adjust the ISO. You can actually increase it. Now, this is something you can't do with a ProRes RAW file in Final Cut Pro 10, which is one of the reasons that I got really frustrated with using Final Cut Pro 10 and the footage from the Nikon Z6. So even though it can do 10-bit RAW, you've got to have the extra thing on top of the camera. It's just a pain. But here you can see we're already getting a pretty good usable image. What else can we do here? Let's go ahead and zoom in on the video. I don't need all that space above my head. And being that we're using a 8K footage, we've got quite a bit of cropping power here. So that's already looking pretty good. What else can we do with it? I've got full access to editing the color temperature. We can boost shadows and highlights, add some contrast. And you can see we're already getting a pretty good usable file here. And all this is done non-destructively. I think maybe getting rid of the highlights was a bad idea. Can add a little bit of color here with the tint tab. Perhaps it's a little too pink. Now, there's all sorts of ways you could edit this, but I basically just do it to taste. And now let's add some curves to it. Now I'd say that's pretty darn good. Now I can make a few more adjustments, and I will here in a moment. But okay, just all on camera raw, we've got a very usable image without doing a whole heck of a lot here. And then we just go over to the regular adjustment tabs that you normally use when you're editing footage. And make some other corrections. Again, just whatever you like the look of. Didn't have to do with any LUTs or anything like that. Now I can add a LUT to this. And that's something that I'll probably go ahead and do. So let's say I want to go ahead and add a LUT to it. My favorite LUTs they use are put up by, what are they called? LUTify.me. So LUTify.me, I've got some videos on my channel about using them with various editing suites for photography. But they've got some really good LUTs that you can implement on top of your footage. And it adds just enough character where it's not too much. And of course, you can always dial it back here in Resolve. So kind of like that one. You see before, that's after. Be a little too harsh here. Okay, I like that LUT. But now, after looking at it, I think I've got a little too much contrast. So I can always dial the contrast back here in the RAW tab. This is just like layers in Photoshop. So you can see all sorts of things you can do with it. that's the main part of the grade. But now here's where you need to make some changes in order to be able to play this back and edit it properly.
And so EVF.
Notice how it's just going to be jerky as can be here.
The EVF is kind of a pain. It's not weather sealed.
I would argue that that is unusable for editing. It is unusable. So check out what I'm going to do here. This decode quality, I'm going to change it to quarter resolution. Now you notice that the footage gets blurry.
So even though it takes great images.
But now I can edit it. Now I can move around the timeline.
It's not a pleasure to use.
So after you get the color grading most of the way you want it and you edit the footage, the last step will be to come back here to that color tab and change it to full resolution. That's way when you export it, you get the best quality possible. So I'm going to go ahead and pause this video, make some adjustments to the footage, and edit it all up, and then we'll do the export, and I'll show you what I do at that point. Lastly, let's do the export. Now I've got it set to the H.265 master. I've already set out my export name, and I've changed it to main 44410, and here's why I'm using that. Now this may be right, might be wrong, but here's my rationale. When I look at the EOS R5 specs, and it shoots in Canon RAW, it shoots in 12-bit and 422 10-bit, which is kind of the highest possible. Now, I don't know much about this stuff, so I went to Wikipedia, and I see that the main 44410 gives you the highest options of the 10-bit 422. And so I figured that's going to help me retain the best quality possible for when I upload to YouTube and let YouTube downsample it as needed. So once I do that, I'm just going to go ahead and start the render. And as far as how long it takes, because we're using optimized media and because I'm using the 1080 Ti to do a lot of the encoding, it almost encodes in real time. It's not bad at all. So I highly recommend, like we talked about earlier, optimize your media. When you do the changes for the Canon RAW, make sure you're doing it in the quarter resolution, edit in proxy mode, quarter resolution, 8K down to 4K, and then the export, not bad. Not bad at all. Okay, tell me if you have any questions. I'll do my best. I am not a professional colorist nor video editor. This is just a hobby of mine, but hopefully you found this helpful. Thanks.